Hello everyone, my name is Jun. I repair watches as a hobby. Today we are looking at a Seiko Quartz watch. Sounds boring? Maybe not. This is a Seiko Dolce from the late 1980s. It's not running and was sold as is. But the dial and hands are in great shape. That's a win. The case, though, is heavily corroded. Pretty much junk. So why did I buy it? Let me explain. This is a standard quartz watch. The second hand ticks once per second. That saves battery life, because continuous motion drains power faster. Now, here is a mechanical watch. Its second hand glides smoothly, what we call a sweeping motion. Technically, it ticks 6 times or more per second, creating a smooth motion. That smooth flow is part of what makes mechanical watches so appealing. Back in the 80s, Seiko aimed to bring that sweep to quartz. This watch has that kind of movement. And being quartz, it's more accurate than mechanical watches. This is it. The second hand sweeps across the dial. Just like a mechanical one. And there is another reason this model caught my eye. See the label on the dial? This Seiko was cased in West Germany. That's rare, because most Seikos were cased in Japan or other Asian countries. So it's a bit of a hidden gem. It's not rare or expensive, but worth picking up. More importantly, I wanted to take it apart and see how Seiko achieved a sweeping second hand in a quartz watch. Let's dive in. This is the Seiko 5S21 movement, developed in the late 80s by Seiko Epson. It's not the spring drive, which came later in the 90s. Spring drive is mechanical, powered by a mainspring, regulated by quartz tech. This 5S21 is pure quartz and uses a Seiko proprietary viscous sweep system to move the second hand smoothly. It's a clever design. Smooth, simple, and efficient. as the base is quartz, the step mortar produces intermittent movement. And a smoothing mechanism turns that into a continuous sweep. No extra battery drain. No complex parts. That smoothing system uses just two special components in the gear train. This hairspring wheel acts like a buffer, storing energy from the step motor. And this viscous rotor works like a brake, smoothing the motion. I try to explain how it works. The battery powers the circuit board, which drives the step motor 4 times per second. The hairspring wheel buffers the motor's steps, feeding steady power to the gear train. Then the damper, filled with thick silicone oil, controls and smooths the motion. Other than that, it's the same as a plain quartz movement. That's the overview of the system. I will link a technical paper in the description for the details. It was written by Seiko engineers. Their rival was tuning fork watches and achieving the smooth hand motion with a quartz watch was their long-held dream. So this system was developed. It's written in Japanese, but you can translate it with Google Translate or similar tool. Alright, let's clean and reassemble. Electrical parts like coils and circuit boards should not be cleaned. And I also left the hairspring wheel and viscous unit untouched because they are not supposed to be cleaned with solvents. I don't show the full assembly in this video, and instead I will link the Seiko's technical guide in the description. Check it out if you want more details. Now I'm assembling the movement following the guide. Jewels, pivots, and holes on the base plate are lubricated before placing the components. Quartz movements have less parts than mechanical ones, but each part is smaller. It was tricky, but great practice for watchmaking. I enjoyed it. I'm replacing the rotor stator and coil block. For quartz movement, I avoid steel tweezers, brass or plastic only. Because steel tweezers get magnetized by the rotor, making it hard to handle parts. I'm placing the hairspring wheel and its intermediate wheel. Those wheels are roughly in place for now, and I will align them properly before installing the bridge. It might be difficult to see how tiny these parts are. The movement is about 24 mm across, roughly the size of a coin. All components must fit on that small plate. I'm checking the placement of each part and aligning the wheels. It took a lot of patience. Once aligned, we can place a bridge. Each pivot must sit perfectly in its jewel or hole. Then we can secure it with screws. Final check. Then I lubricate the pivots on this side. The difficult part is done. I'm reinstalling the electronics, the insulator, battery terminal, and the circuit block. This movement was only produced for a few years. Why Seiko discontinued it? I don't know. But maybe because they moved onto spring drive. I learned about spring drive at the Seiko Museum in Tokyo. It's impressive, but I think it's too complex and pricey. Not for everyone. I wonder if Seiko will ever bring back this simpler sweep second system. Probably not. Anyway, the movement is reassembled. The case is too corroded to fix. I got this watch for about 2,000 yen, less than 15 US dollars. My original plan was to transplant the movement into a new case. But as you can see, I changed my mind. This Seiko has a Swiss-made case and assembled in West Germany. That's reason enough to keep it original. Despite the damage. Just to be clear, again, this isn't a rare or valuable watch in Japan. Some models, like the rectangular-shaped ones, cost more, but most 5S21 watches go for under 10,000 yen on Yahoo Japan. Here is the finished watch. Look at that smooth motion. Most people would assume it's mechanical. Actually, it's much smoother, more accurate, and far more affordable. That's about it. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm already working on the next piece, so see you soon. Until then, take care.